What's up, everybody? Welcome to the day 330 making song ringer, and I'm fixing bugs still. So I'm still working on this bug where I've got it mostly fixed, but didn't have much more time yesterday to get any development done. So I'm working on this bug where you kill the mini boss and you don't get the item. What's up, Zilton? You made some enemies? Right on. Cool. Yeah, how you doing? Oh, hold on. Let me get the sound going. Shit, I was having a problem with the sound yesterday. I think it should be okay now. So how's your day going, Tilton? La 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 la. Yeah, I think the sound's okay. Yesterday it was peaking like real high. Let me know if that's too loud. If this game sound is too loud, I will turn it down. Okay, so there's some new code that makes the item pop out of the enemy like that, and also land on some appropriate area. It's going good? Sweet. So the next thing I want to do is there's a few more things on my list here. Trying the item flying out of the mini boss in other areas, so we'll do that. Let's put some players somewhere random, somewhere else. This 1110 is a good location to keep around, though. So let's try 760. My goal here is to fight this mini boss in a different area and just see if that different area reveals anything that might be an issue. So here we go. Here's an area. Try. This is working all right. Let's try one more area. Maybe 1416. Something like this. Need to find it. Here we go. Okay. This is a screenshot of your rhythm recall. Page not found. Oh, okay. Okay, let's do that again. This time I'm gonna make it fight. Yeah, so that's good. I'm gonna try the mini boss now, the other mini boss. Nice, this is a sprite sheet for your enemy? Looks cool, man. Nice. Right on. Hey, what's up, Emma? So now I'm going to give the player the right items so we get to see this other boss. We got the top hat. And we don't have compass zero. Okay, try to play this guy in the same area. Just verifying that these bosses drop their items just fine and that this bug is fixed. Man, my ear keeps popping. Hey, what's up, Arcane? Yeah, isn't that a fun feeling? Like being excited about developing a game? I acquired the item, it paused the game, showed me the item, and then the items popped out of him. So that's okay, I guess. All right, and if I should be able to just use this. Oops. Oh, no, use this. Yeah, so there's showing me dungeon one. Okay, good. Tested that. I'm gonna test now that the items should fly out of the enemies in the dungeons as well. So I need to go to the dungeons and find an area where it's got an enemy that's hiding an item inside. What's up, Zanger? Hey. So I'm working on some bugs today. I'm working on getting an alpha update out, or not alpha, beta. Working on getting an update out for the game. So this will be probably this Thursday or Friday. Maximum this Saturday I'll get the update finished and out on Steam. So I'm working on bugs and stuff to fix that. See, now I need to know of an area that has a hidden item. I should make sure that I have no keys. And it'd probably be better to go to a higher dungeon because they're going to have more items in them. So maybe I'll just go to dungeon 9 straight off. Treble's design will be? Oh! And also, I'm going to turn off all the maps and compasses. And put the player, oh, maybe take off all the bomb containers too. Or maybe keep a couple of them. Let's take them all off. All right, cool. Human, treble. All right, so put the player at 9. And what I'm looking for here is an area where it has an enemy that's hiding an item. Doesn't appear there was one there. Bug keys to kill all these enemies quickly. And just, I'm looking for an enemy that's gonna pop out an item. That's a reward item. That doesn't count. Not having much luck here. Oh, there we go. Right when I say that. Okay, cool. Save the game there. And let's test that again. Awesome, so I did drop the item, got that key card. I'm gonna do this again, and I'm gonna make sure that even if the enemy dies, like, over that hole in the middle, that the item should still fly out and land on some actual... Dude, let's get to all these guys, like, way up here. Try that again. No, Bafu's not dead. He's just not here right now. Yeah, Boogie's, I'm not sure where Boogie is, so Boogie's gotta start him up. Whoops. Oh, damn. Here I am. I'm standing way up here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so I killed all those guys above the sky. They fell into the sky, but still the item fell on some land, and I'm able to get to that land as well. So I can, even though, let's turn off God mode. Yeah, I'm not no longer in God mode. I can still pick that item up. Awesome. Yes, this does work quite well. Okay, that's one more thing checked, done, awesome. Let's get that right there, taken off. Yeah, the next thing I wanna do is lower the overall amount of items that you get from trees and bushes per area. So sometimes when you're in some bushes, or you're in an area where you get some bushes, it can be really, you can get a ton of items. And now that the items fly out to land, it's also really easy to get just like a ton of diamonds from being in an area with lots of trees. I want the player to have some bombs. And we go back to this area that I noticed had a lot of trees, 760. Yeah, this place has a ton of trees. Oh, but no Karsh. It'd be better if this had a Karsh. Yeah, there's an area, I think it's at 12.10, where it's really obvious that there's too many items because you have this Karsh here, and the Karsh shoots these poison bubbles, and the poison bubbles hit all the trees. So just by sitting here, I can get items. That one flew right in my hands. Yeah. So as you can tell, the overall amount of items from trees and bushes per area. I got an idea. What right now it puts the bushes, or it gives the bushes and trees items. I could make it so that it requires a bush or a tree to have a blank space around it in order to give it an item. So I'm gonna go to where it creates a bush tile. I guess it doesn't even do it to the trees. I thought it did. That's weird. Yeah, it gives it an item component. So if I made it so that every single bush or tree had the chance Yeah, I think this would work if I make it so it requires that one of the tiles around it is empty. Let's do that. If this See if our tiles would work. Yeah, so this is checking. If I were to put K tile none here, it would be checking if it's not none and return false. meaning it requires every single tile around it to be of the type that we've got. So that doesn't work. So we're going to check for ktile none. Before we add the item. So is tile none, x minus one, x plus one, y minus one, y plus one. There we go. So now we should have significantly less of these items. It's only gonna do it if there's an empty tile around that bush or that tree. And then I'll make this more universal, so we can apply the same method to the trees, because right now it looks like the trees are not being... Yeah, so it still disturbs them. Significantly less items. This is good. So we've got a couple. Any of these edge tiles are going to be have a chance to have an item. And that chance might be a little high, actually. It does still seem like we're getting a good number of items here. Oh, these are trees. No wonder this is not really counting. All these top ones are bushes. Yeah, okay, so this is still a little bit of high priority or probability. Let's go half that probability. Yeah, see, even at half that probability, we're still getting a lot of items, so... But nowhere near where it was. It was just way too many items in those trees and bushes. Okay, good. Now let's make this a universal, reusable function. So we'll call this add Rocket Bunny. What's up, buddy? Heyo. How's it going? Add nature item. I'm not sure what this is. Oh, we'll call this the jostle item. Give it a system int. And a random number. And I guess we should be able to put a minimum probability here. I need your opinion. Should I get used to C# as a whole and then get used to Unity? Or should I get used to using Unity while learning C#? Well, man, that's a great question. I can't really answer that very well for you because I really haven't used Unity that extensively, but I would recommend myself that you get used to Unity first and learn C# along with Unity, because the point of you learning Unity is to learn to get familiar with how to develop games with it, right? And you'll get better results out of what you're trying to do if you're learning Unity first of all and not necessarily C#. C# is a great language to learn and everything, but without the whole overall game development understanding and all that, I think the overall game development is a little more important, personally. The Grim Gary. What's up? Today I'm fixing some bugs. I'm working on getting an update out for the beta version of Songbringer to Steam by this Thursday or Friday, something like that. Maybe Saturday. So I'm just fixing up little bugs here and there. Yeah. How's it going, Rocket Bunny? How are you liking Unity overall so far? I've been seeing you making some really good progress. And that's awesome. Oh, this will need an area. Oh, now we need X as well. Damn. Int X, int Y, blah, 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 blah. Gonna try and play again this weekend then? Sweet. Awesome, Gary. Cool. I really appreciate you guys playing the game so much, too. It's great. I'm getting so much great feedback and so many good bug reports. Jonah19, what's up? How are the parties? The parties were really awesome, actually. I've been to a couple of parties this week so far, and the ones last night were hilarious, man. We had a good crew of people. I've met some really fun people so far in my by demoing the game and some of these latest like demo nights and stuff like that. I've met some people and made some new friends. I'm really excited. We had some really good times last night. It ended with us outside of the GitHub party. So GitHub actually threw a pretty cool party last night, and it was in their kitchen area or whatever. And they had free booze, and like people were demoing their games, and they had food, and I had some great conversations with some people about AR versus VR. That was interesting. And you know, just got to meet a lot of great people. I met a game agent, and I met like some other, you know, sort of important people, but I also met a lot of other great game developers. And it's just really great to be at those parties and stuff like that. And like, and know that you're not alone. You know what I mean? Making games, a lot of the times it can be real lonely, you know, for a lot of game developers, you know what I mean? A lot of game developers aren't live streaming, and they don't have like a great community of you, like people like you guys. So for them to kind of share their ideas and share their games and stuff like that, it's really cool to interact with people, get to know people like myself, you know, that are game developers and all that. So did the stream freeze? It looks all right. What's one more question? What does abstract mean in C#? I don't know. Let me see if I can help you understand that. Abstract modifier, in your case, is the thing being modified as a missing or incomplete implementation. Oh, abstract just means that it's in C++, the analog would be a pure virtual class or pure virtual function. It simply just means that abstract means that you're creating a class or a function or something that that cannot be instantiated. You know what instantiated means? Instantiated is means like, okay, for example, here's an int. This is a class, right? Or a structure, basically the same thing. This is the definition of this object, for example. You know what I mean? This is a, I would call it a class or a struct or whatever. But if this were a pure virtual or an abstract class, it would mean that you can't create an object of that type. You would have to create an object of a subclass or a, you know, a descendant or whatever of that class. If that doesn't make sense to you yet, don't worry about it. It's really kind of a advanced concept that you're probably not going to even need to use that much, especially in your first year of learning programming and stuff like that. Grim Gary is a very lonely process, even with others. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. You're not alone. Hardboiled, what's up, man? And we're still working on bugs here.
You're not alone.
What?
You're just having some idiotic dreams. Does that mean we can make out?
Scott Pilgrim versus the World? I haven't seen that one. I gotta see it. Yeah, you're welcome, Racket Bunny. I hope I helped. Yeah, so Hardboiled just working on some more bugs, working on getting the version updated. So by this Thursday, Friday, something like that, I'm gonna have another update up to Steam. How's it going playing Borderlands? How you liking it? Okay, there. Now we have an add jostle item function. And we can use that function here and to create tree tile as well. We already got, let's see this, this get ran 3F. I guess I don't need to even pass that in anymore like that, but oh well. There we go. So the trees will have a 5% chance of having an item. Let's see what that's like. Love the game? Cool. Thursday's in an hour for you. Oh, that's right. It's coming too soon. It's probably not going to be Thursday that I get this update finished. There's still so much left to do. I really want to make the bosses better for this update. But I do have to get a lot of bugs fixed, so that's what I'm working on right now. Good. I do want to see if the trees in particular can have items. First thunderstorm? Really? Interesting. We've been having a lot of rain here. It's been really great. PMC, what's up, man? You have a question. How many hits is it supposed to take to break those spiderweb eggs? It depends on the dungeon. I spent a really long time trying to break it and I can't, but I broke it once. That was when I started. Yeah, the spiderweb eggs, they have some hit points for sure, and they get more and more per dungeon. But really, you should only, it should only take, let's see. They have a health of 2.75 to 3.5. So yeah, it should take you, it should take you 2 to 4 hits, 2 to 4 hits with the sword to kill a spider nest. But keep in mind that it distributes damage. So if your sword attack is hitting multiple things at once, you're not doing as much damage to all those things. So for example, if you're hitting even some pillars while you're hitting that spider sack, then it's going to distribute the damage a little bit, and it might take a little while longer to defeat it. Teek, what's up? Teek's reporting a black screen, and oh, there is. Let me see if I can reset it. Okay, so I reset the stream there. Comcast fault. Okay, I need to make sure that this is working. This add jostle item is working for trees in particular. Okay, so let's do this. I'll make it a probability of 1 if it's a tree. Video. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Thanks for noticing. Thanks for letting me know. It doesn't always work. Like, the stream might go out here in another second or so. Who the hell knows? Okay. Yeah, all right, good. So I just hit those trees, and we definitely have some items flying out of those. Awesome. Okay, so that is done. Add jostle item. Awesome. Oh, PMC. Yeah, sorry. I just answered that question. Okay. So what I was saying is, it should take between 2 and 4 hits normally to kill one of those spider sacks. But the thing is, if your sword is hitting more than one thing at once, it will distribute the damage across those things. So it may take many more swings if you're hitting 2 things at once. So if you're hitting the spider sack and you're hitting some spiders, or if you're hitting the spider sack and you're hitting some pillars at the same time, it's going to take a lot more hits. And things are changing a little bit with this next update. Before, it would distribute your damage over... I don't know. I actually know how to... I'm not sure if this is actually right, what I'm trying to say here. So yeah, never mind. The first part of your modding API came to life today? Cool. Nice. Oh yeah, Jonah, that's a good point. Bombs work a little bit differently in how their damage is distributed. So they do a lot of damage always. You bombed it 7 times and it didn't die? That definitely should have killed it. One bomb should kill one of those guys. That's really weird. Can you reproduce that, PMC? Can you get to that same area? And does it always do that for you in that same area? If so, please let me know what area approximately that is and what your world seed is. Like, if you can say, okay, it's this world seed, and it's in dungeon 1, even, that's enough for me to go and find it. So, okay, next bug on the list. I want to fix up the drop boss right now. Maybe. Okay, cool. Awesome. Yeah, sweet. Yeah, a recorded video or something would be great too, but especially the World Seed and what dungeon. Yeah, I'm gonna go fix up the drop boss now. The drop boss is almost cool now. He's a lot cooler than he used to be. There's a few more things I want to do to fix him up and make him super awesome. So the drop boss, get that opened. What were the two thoughts I had? Oh yeah, get Ran Smart to work. And oh, and he's getting hit delay. Okay. Yeah, so two more little refinements and this boss will be even better. By the way, the Sandy Dungeon boss room could use a barricade when you enter, like that of the mini boss encounter. Yeah, well, I'm not so concerned about that dungeon right now. Like I said, that's a totally unfinished dungeon, and it's not even, I really should not even put that dungeon in the game at this point. And it's going to be totally different, so there's really no need for me to go put barricades in there and try and make it playable, because it's going to change, man. It's going to change a lot. That dungeon style is not even going to be like that. I'm actually considering maybe even just taking it out for now, because it's just it's always getting so many bug reports and stuff, and I just haven't had time to go specifically work on that dungeon style yet. Okay, so yeah, I want the drop boss to become more and more intelligent as you get through the dungeon. So dungeon one, he's sort of intelligent. By dungeon nine, he's fully intelligent. And then bosses can use their intelligence for certain things like this, where he spawns these rocks that fall from the ceiling. If he's really intelligent, he can drop a ton of them. And if he's not that intelligent, he can only drop a few. So there's a bit of code right now in world that creates the foes, and it gives foes maximum intelligence if they're a boss, I believe. No, hardboiled. There, I was talking about taking it out, but putting in another type of dungeon. So keeping the, it will still have level three. I mean, or I could just keep doing what I'm doing and ignore the fact that level three is really messed up and just fix it when I get to it, you know? Get to when I finally get to actually designing that dungeon as it's supposed to be. There's somewhere where it puts the boss at maximum intelligence. Maybe it's when it creates the foe. Oh yeah, here it is. What? It looks like this logic is crazy. set a breakpoint there and see what intelligence this guy actually has. Back to Lyric, right on. What's up, Voice of Grog? Yo. You vote to temporarily remove from the game? Okay. Alright, good to know. Oh, if this is Flag's boss or Z is less than negative num levels. Yeah, so that puts maximum intelligence. And difficulty becomes Aripaz.Z over 9. So, yeah, I think this is where we want to just go. Intelligence becomes 1, difficulty 0.1111. Yeah, we don't want that. Okay, we want intelligence. Just take that out completely. There. So now when we run it, we should have a good intelligence. Because the Verloc room is not accessible. Well, yeah, I can. So I can just temporarily fix that one at least. That's kind of a critical one. Yeah, Teak, yep, it turned out to be Snakespear. William Snakespear. Okay, so now we got difficulty 0.111, intelligence 0. I thought intelligence should have been... Oh, yeah, intelligence should be the same as difficulty here. And it shouldn't be 9. It should be world number levels. Yeah, in fact, screw all that code. We just want intelligence over float. Okay, world num levels. Let's see it again. Okay, so my goal here is to make this Throb boss guy, all the bosses, I want them to have increasing intelligence. So dungeon 1, they have a tiny bit of intelligence. By dungeon 9, they have full intelligence. And that way, the AI for the bosses can grow as the dungeons grow. All right, so we have intelligence 0.11111. Difficulty, same. Yeah, sorry, Bafu's offline. I'm not sure where he's at today. So create being. So I'm gonna make sure that create being also applies the right intelligence. I did have this old thing called smart, which always maximized the intelligence. I don't know if that's a good idea to keep that in. Big Mac Dev, what's up? We see how many enemies are still using that smart flag. So the blob mini boss has smart 1. Actually, I guess that flag does work. I do want that blob mini boss to be really intelligent. It makes him really kind of sneaky and fast. Drop mini boss, same thing. These are Ifran smart, okay. I kind of want to put this at the top here, so it becomes pretty apparent. Same here. Oops. All right. So that should apply the intelligence. EAI intelligence. Yep, cool. Buffoo's in Weekend at Bernie's. He is. Weekend at Bernie's. That's a good movie. Big Mac, PMC, I can't seem to make it work again, but it happened in level 2 and the seed name was Pizza. Okay. Well, I guess I can kind of file that as a possible bug. Big Mac, gonna have my first iOS app on the store as a social network. I'm starting in the third fiscal quarter 2016. I'm launching an LLC. Wow, congratulations, man. That's super exciting. Code is amazing, isn't it? Code is awesome. I love coding. I'm a coder at heart. I'm pretty surprised, though, that most people think of me as an artist. Like, all the people I've met at GDC so far, they're like, oh, so you're an artist, right? Like, well, that's the newest of my, I'm pretty much an amateur artist, and I'd consider myself a professional programmer for sure. So yes, code is amazing. Code is poetry. Zilton started working on a code in Game Boy games. Yeah. Nice. Games are art. They definitely are. They're interactive art. It's like, almost cooler than art. And the code is an art form too. That's true. Amen. If you can draw, you're an artist, right? I know. Coding definitely is art. It definitely is an art form. And that's what's so beautiful about making games, is that it combines so many art forms into this. When the art forms that you get to use as a developer of games are amazing. It's like really fulfilling to put so many art forms into one creation. You got visual art, you got sonic art, you've got coding art, you've got storytelling, you've got the art form of business. That's an art form in itself. You put all those together, and then from the player's perspective, you've got an interactive art form. It's like cooler than a movie. It's like watching a movie, but better, because you can interact with it. Things can change because of what you do and what you choose, and your brain is more into it, and you can become more immersed in that form of entertainment than you could with a movie sometimes. Coding games is hard. It is. Santa card still counts. Coding games is like learning kung fu as a wizard, for sure. For sure it is. Yeah, I love making games. I'm really fulfilled in what I do in life. Especially doing it all myself now. It's really amazing to make every aspect of a game. Because the whole vision for this game, Songbringer, can be 100% cohesive. You know, there's no me sharing this idea with somebody else and them possibly saying, nope, I think it should do that. You know, or there's no sharing a vision with someone else and then them not quite creating the vision how you would want to. So that's what's so fulfilling about making games alone. Not necessarily alone, but just all one, you know, as one person. Because I definitely don't feel alone. I get to share with you guys every day. And Voice of Grog, have any tattoos? Yes, I do, but they're not coding related. You're getting your first tattoo this week? Something nerdy enough? Maybe get a jib? Yeah, I got lots of tattoos. These are kind of nerdy in the sense that this is the same language I'm using in the game. And then I've got like a whole bunch of tattoos on this arm. And I do have one super nerdy tattoo. Not really nerdy, but like definitely silly. This is if you can see this, I'm not sure if you can, but it's SpongeBob and he's on fire. So that's just crazy. I still laugh at it, just thinking the fact that I have SpongeBob on my arm. It totally, it's right. So these ones right here, these were all bamboo tattoos. Actually, bamboo tattoos are really cool. Guns? I don't actually have guns, do I? SpongeBob! SpongeBob! Right? Yes, he does. He does live in a pineapple under the sea. He has a friend named... What's his friend's name? Why do I want to call him Jim all of a sudden? It's not Jim. Why can't I remember SpongeBob's friend's name? Jason? It's not Jason. God. Gigas? Patrick! That's right! Patrick. Duh. Come on, for sure, really, right? I should go sit in, like, prison for a minute, like, nerd prison, because I forgot Patrick's name. I know, needles in your arms for 6 hours, it sucks. It definitely sucks. This one on the inside of the arm took, like, 8 hours, and it was hell. Squidward, yes. What's his boss's name? His boss's name? Well, now you know how super geeky I am. SpongeBob tattoo. Who does that? Who gets a freaking SpongeBob tattoo? Mr. Krabs, that's right. You taking off? Okay. Gary the Snail. That's right. Oh, Gary's great. The Snail. He's... Oh, yeah. I love the SpongeBob movie. That's like one of my favorites. There's a couple movies now, right? I think I've only seen one of the movies. I think this is all good. It's creating an enemy with intelligence now. So let's go to the Dungeon 9's boss. Make sure that boss has full intelligence. Yep. She knows. What's great is when you do funny stuff like that and someone still loves you, you know that person really loves you. You know what I mean? You get a SpongeBob tattoo, the person you're with still loves you. That's a pretty good sign, right? Or you had the tattoo already and they ended up actually loving you. Breakpoint. Check this guy's intelligence. You made the bug work again. Oh. With another seed. Saber level 1. Okay. I know the brain enemy is tough, right? I did make him so you only encounter those brain enemies in the higher dungeons. So there's that. Okay, so you got another encounter with an you couldn't kill this the sack in Saber Dungeon 1. Okay. Love's not about the amazing things you do. It's about someone tolerating the crazy shit you managed to pull off in a cute way. Right? Best SpongeBob? It's not loading. Why is the link not loading? Oh, here we go. Nobody cares. Pedro, what's up? Welcome to the stream, man. All right. So let's see if he's got full intelligence now. This should be 1.0 intelligence. Yep, we got 1.0 intelligence. Should be 1.0 difficulty as well. Great. Okay, cool. So now we can start putting two and two together. So the first enemy, we'll make it so he drops like one. Always just like one. One rock. Drop boss. Right, yeah, so here we go. Spawns one rock. If ran smart, then it spawns a bunch more. So if I run it now, it should only drop one rock on the screen. How are the parties? Lots of pretty ladies? No, not lots of pretty ladies, man. There were a lot of pretty guys sharing their games. Now the parties were really great, actually. They're really, really fun. Went to like this one party last night where had some other game developers I knew already from some of the events I've been at recently, and it's really fun because I'm really starting to make some friends here in the Bay Area that are also in the game development scene, and we had a lot of fun. At the end, we tried to climb a telephone pole. It was great. We were all kind of drunk and stuff, and we went to this GitHub party. Got to meet a lot of different people, lots of other game developers. Just one of those things where you realize you're not alone. You know what I mean? Like, there's so many other people out there that are actually doing game development. It's just that we live all over the world. It's really cool that we can go to something like GDC, though, and see everybody. SpongeBob. Japanese McDonald's SpongeBob commercial? Nice one. Nice. Testing your thesis? Sweet. No, not gonna look for you. Pedro, the responsible adult, is here. Did I see Rami? No, I didn't see Rami or anybody else famous. No, I was looking around. I was like, maybe I'll see, you know, like I'm aware of a lot of, you know, cool people that I kind of look up to. I haven't seen that anybody, you know, but I'm not at Rocket Bunny. I'm not actually at GDC at the actual conference. And I think if I was at the actual conference, I would probably meet a lot of more people. So maybe next year I'll have the cash and I'll be able to actually go to the conference and, you know, hang out all week and not be, you know, pressured for time to get an update out for the game and stuff like that. So nice dolphin noise. The guns?
Put down your guns.
What? These guns?
That's crazy. I've never seen that channel. Can you ban them? No. Don't ban them. Ban first, ask questions later. Yeah, I'm sure Rami Ismail's there. I'm sure there's like, dude, every freaking game developer in the world is here in this city right now. I'm telling you, man, just about anybody that's in game development is here at GDC. It's like the biggest conglomeration of game developers. You know, E3 is huge too, but like, and other conferences are big too. Rezzed and, man, all the other ones, but GDC is the one where all the game developers go to because for many reasons, but there's a lot of industry, you know, like finding jobs. There's lots of finding work going on at this type of thing, or learning the new things that are in game development and stuff like that. Yeah, you wish you could come? Yeah, maybe one day you will. Don't need to hype more? Sorry, I don't mean to hype. I'm just saying, you know, that's what it's like. That's what it's like at it. Hell, I'm not trying to hype it. I'm not even there, technically. I don't even have a ticket to go. Okay, so yeah, back to this drop boss. This guy should drop one rock. Started moving before he was done. Maybe the delay is not working anymore. Okay, so yeah, he dropped one rock. That's great. Let's make sure he keeps on dropping about one rock. Good. Okay, cool. So then we'll go to the next guy, this one at the level 9, and he should drop like a ton of rocks. All aboard the hype train. Yeah, cool. So he dropped a ton of rocks. Great. Great, 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 great. Now we can do something like this. Every one of these, I could put an if ran smart around it. So, here at Dungeon 9, you should drop like a ton of these rocks. And then at Dungeon 1, it will always drop about one rock. Dungeon 5 would maybe drop around 5 rocks. It's all random though. It's a random roll against their intelligence. So it kind of depends. So this, that worked. Let's check again the first one. I wish you filmed you trying to climb a telephone pole. I know, right? There are a lot of funny moments last night that I wish were on film. We were all kind of drunk, that's for sure. Alright, okay, the one thing I don't like is that it really should, he should drop at least a few rocks. So let's do at least 4, and then the rest will be based on intelligence. Yes, increasing difficulty with the same type of boss. Yeah. So what my goal for today is to make it so this guy feels he feels the same, or he feels a lot more difficult at level 9, right? This should be at level 9, this guy should be very difficult to fight. At level 1, he should be, you know, pretty reasonable. Yes, there's something wrong with the delay feature. He's supposed to stop and not move. When this rock fall happens, he says it's there none. Delay 1.882. Alright, let's see this again. I want to get this fixed. This whole delay. This is pretty important. He starts Yeah, he puts his hammer in the air, and then all of a sudden, oh, something else too. Small explosion. I think this might be the need this. If you saw Phil Fish, you'd beg him to make Fizz too. I wonder if he even goes. Alright, something is definitely wrong with the delay. I'm gonna check out the AI system. Wait. Let me verify one thing. Say I set the delay to something real long, like 4 seconds for the rock fall. Yeah, see, that didn't work either. Can you explain how that text file works? Is it a special scripting language you created? Oh, yeah. So Pedro just sent you a link there. Oh, wait, Pedro. Sorry. Yeah, Pedro gave you the link there. It's called Valtry. Valtry is what does what processes all this data, TJ. But this, what we're talking about here, this behavior thing is a little bit different. This is what's called a behavior tree. And I wrote this custom for this game, and it's simply just, if you want to look up how behavior trees work, just look for behavior trees and how they, do a Google search basically for behavior trees, and that kind of explains what this is. This is an AI system where I don't have to write any new code to write an enemy. It's basically a scripting language, but all it is a behavior tree, and the tree basically has a selects and sequences, and within each select or sequence you can have all these different things, but the basic gist is this: a select does one thing, a sequence does all things, and anything will stop if an if fails. Actually, each one of these lines, every single line, either returns true or false. It's kind of like a state machine. But I highly recommend checking out behavior trees and kind of, maybe read an article about how they work. And that will explain it a lot better than I'm trying to here in just a minute. Is there a good game conference in Europe, preferably Germany? Yes, there is. There's Res in the UK. Oh yeah, EGX Res. So just look for, you can look for Res here online. It's egx.net/res. But that one's London. I think there really is a game developer conference in Germany. What's that one called? GDC Europe? Yeah, Cologne, Germany. There you go, GDC Europe. It's in August. August 15th through 16th. So there you go, Teek. There's your German game developer conference. It's in Cologne. Botfu's at GDC. What exactly does Rapid Game do, and how does it do it? Rapid Game is just a tool for pre-building Cocos 2DX, basically. So if you're not using Cocos 2DX, you don't need Rapid Game. Yep, you're welcome. All right, so I need to fix up this delay, because obviously I'm setting a delay of 5 seconds right there. And he immediately starts walking after it. Something wrong there. Yeah, he should definitely not be walking yet. Okay. Oh, first thing I can do is turn on debug level 2. How green light turns out? All right. I gotta pay attention here. So I'm looking at the top of his head at what behavior he's currently running. Taunt something impulse. Okay, this time I'm gonna set the time scale real low so I can watch that happen a lot slower. Taunt. Impulse. I still didn't even see it. He's stuck on the 31st of February. Oh, I get it. Bapu's attacking Robotron. That's right. You guys didn't know, but Bapu's a pretty amazing weapon. He's killing the entire Marvel Universe. Okay, so if you're just tuning in, I'm working on a little bug with enemies where it's not delaying. This command in behavior tree called delay should make it so it doesn't even run the behavior tree for a minute. Okay, well, I'm gonna look at the delay timer now. AI system. Oh my God, there's no delay timer being run. Oh, here it is, behave. Okay. EAI delay timer minus equals delta. If it's greater than 0, return. See, that seems like it should work. What could be happening is it could be changing the delay timer somewhere. Delay RAND. Why would I be doing that ever? Yeah. Yeah, this is horrible. Plus equals up to one delay. That's not right. Once again, we should get a made up of data and look for anything that is delay rand. Frogs use it. Okay, I'm getting rid of this. Only the frog uses this. And this is what it should be. E delay timer equals parse rand range float val 0 or stir val 0. And then the frog, instead of delay rand, this should just be delay 0.0 to 1.0. Oh, and I do want to keep this code around for a second because I want to understand what the hell is going wrong here before I just check it in. And this might not even work, so let's see if this is helping. Right? Yeah. Didn't help. Okay, next thing I want to do is, so that does confirm that basically there's something else going on besides, yeah, okay, so I can get rid of that code now. Yeah, I want to show the fact that an AI is being delayed. So in the debug, you should have a tick. All right, so this first thing where it puts out its current label, if the AI has a delay timer that's greater than zero, or it only puts out the label if it has no delay timer. So now when it delays, it'll take off the thing above its head. It seems to me that basically it's calling impulse. Okay, I need to track this a little bit closer. So instead of, I'm just gonna log out what this AI has for each one of its frames. Oh, and also I'm gonna turn on only foes so we don't get this for like a lot of, oh, we already got only foes. Should remember that that's on. All right. Yeah, so we got OnlyFoes. So basically, there's only one entity here, which is running an AI component. Oh, wait, no. We need to check if this is a foe. Because there's also Jib. Kung Fu Panda made more money than Deadpool. Zootopia got 99%. Whoa. Have you seen it? You like it? All right, so I'm putting out some debug data every single tick. So I can just watch exactly what sequence it's running. Here we are, taunt. It goes immediately from taunt to impulse. Impulse. Weird. It never clicks into rock fall. Oh, I guess that's because the sequence never completes itself. Oh, we really don't need this move cameras thing. Moved cameras. Okay, I think I understand what's going on now. I'm not making any noise. I am making noise. La 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 la. It looks like we're okay. Okay, I'm starting to understand. I think what's going on is that this... Oh, that totally is. Oh, I totally get it now. Oh my god. Okay. Here's what's going on. This AI, look at this. It's this sequence right here. Ultimately, this sequence command right here returns true or false. It returns true if everything in the whole sequence returns true. That gets cut short though. This if ran smart. Can get cut short. If it's not smart enough, it's going to return false. And then that sequence is not considered as if it were complete. So that's why it's not working. It's calling delay, but then it immediately goes, okay, it gets to this point right here and it goes, if ran smart, no. It failed. Then it fails this sequence and it goes on to the next sequence. That it can run, and it's probably not going to be hammer time, so it runs impulse and immediately gives it a dirt target. And there you go. That's why that all happens. So I need to, now that I understand what's going on, I can try to think of the best way to actually handle this. Because I don't want this to happen in the future again. I don't want it to accidentally not have a delay. How could it not have a delay? Hold on. I'm pretty sure I'm showing the delay timer, right? Oh no, I'm not. Oh, this is supposed to be delay timer. All right, let's get some debug data here. By the way, Wizard, I gave the key to Chaotic. Nice. He promised to play the game and give feedback. All right, nice. Right on. Yeah, Jonah, that might be one way to do it, like force succeed. Or maybe the smart thing to do would be make it succeed if it runs anything inside its sequence that does succeed. But this is kind of fundamental things here. What's up, Chaotic? Welcome. Congratulations on getting a Steam key. Hope you enjoy, man. Here we go. Now we got delays being shown, what sequence is currently being run. And we can see what's going on for real. So right here, taunt. It's got a good delay going on. It's like taunt. That's the last sequence that it ran. And then it goes impulse because it doesn't ever actually succeed. So even though impulse has a delay timer running already, How to fix this? Good to have friends like these. Yeah. One option to fix this would be to make sequences succeed if any bit of the sequence succeeds. But that's really going to mess with a lot. In fact, that might break the entire behavior system. Another option is to make it so the AI, the behavior does not try and run another sequence if it has suddenly gained a delay timer in one of its other sequences. Huh, wow, this is one I might need to think about for a minute. What have I changed so far in this update? Moved around those smarts. I've added this smartness to the rocks falling. Random delays are better. Delays can be random. Now that I think about it, this bit right here is probably wrong. I want it to show whatever is the last sequence that it ran, no matter if it currently has a delay. So I'm going to take that out for now. Say, let me get to the point of code which is kind of where we're. The code that's being discussed right now is right here. Behavior type sequence and behavior type select. See, sequence returns true ultimately if all of its children return true. If any of its children return false, it returns false. And that's the way it's meant to be. Select is different. It returns true if even one of its children succeeds. So, I guess what I should be doing here is using a select. But see, no, a select is different because a select finishes the second one of its children succeeds. I am tempted to try this with behaviors returning true even if one of their children succeeds. When do we get a name stuff? I don't know. Maybe next week. Maybe next week I might be able to get some new stuff done by then. Right now I'm in bug fix mode. I'm going to be in bug fix mode until this update gets released. So there's no way I can do any kind of naming stuff or any new things until I get these bugs fixed. I don't know what to do. Really, the thing that should happen is if... Jonah, I think it's called Succeeder. A decorator node that returns success even if one of the children nodes fails. Really? So maybe there should be a different... Yeah, Jonah, this might be the way to do it. Yeah. To add, instead of just sequences and selects, there's another one called Succeed. Or Succeeder. TJ, are all your streams mostly code-oriented? No, they're not. Because I follow many developers, and usually they only stream when they are doing art. So I like this stream a lot. Awesome. No, I'd say most of my streams are code-oriented. I don't know. Sometimes they're 50-50. I do a lot of pixel art on the streams, too. And I also do music on the streams and sound effects. So... yeah, I'm not exactly sure. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this, Jonah. I'm gonna add a new type of fundamental sequence type of behavior called Succeeder. All right, let's just do it. Sequence, select. I'm gonna call this succeed. All right, here we go. Compiling. Let's get that word added. And add an appropriate AI system. Branch here, succeed. And marketing, that's true. I do marketing sometimes, but more rare than the other stuff. Mod foo. Okay, so behavior succeed returns true if any succeed. All right. Okay, so we have a bool ret, false start. If success, ret becomes true. If failure, we break from the loop. We return ret. And verbosity is greater than zero. And num value is greater than zero. We set the label. And this is going to need to be and ret. Let's put that at the beginning so it's a little more clear. Yeah, so if this behavior succeeds in any way, any one of its children succeeds, and we've got verbosity on, it sets it to the name of this succeed sequence or whatever. Then it go, okay, so let me just think of this through, make sure this, talk this through, so this is right. Starts at ret false. It loops over all the children of that behavior. And it goes, if we run a successful behave on that, we've got ret true, but it continues to keep on working on the next child. If any of the children fail, it simply just breaks from the loop. And then, but still returns true if one of them succeeded, and still sets the label. I think this is right, Jonah. I think this is right. So is that, that's really a thing, huh? Bot foo's alive. No, you're not dying. No, Zilton. Oh, here we go. Yeah, succeeder. Succeeder. What's successor? No. Oh, we also have other kinds of decorators, like an inverter returns the opposite. Failure repeater, repeat until fail, repeat until succeed, limiter. Wow, so many other ways to do this, huh? I like the simplicity of the way it works right now, though. But this succeeder is really necessary. Oh, you could put an inverter on a succeeder, and that would make it a normal sequence. Oh, random selectors. I never even thought about a random selector. Wow, there's really a lot more complexity you can add to behavior trees than I was ever aware of. But good to know, good to know. So we should have a beat. So now when I run the game, it shouldn't have broken anything. Everything should still run the same. Now let's go back to his rockfall sequence. His rockfall sequence has the possibility of returning, of having it fail because it's using this if ran smart stuff. But we want it to continue running. We want it to, that to succeed no matter what. So we're going to call it succeed rockfall. And now what we should see happen is it should stay delayed and it should also say rockfall above his head. Taunt rockfall. Yeah. Bam! It worked! High five, Jonah! It totally worked on the first try. I hope y'all recognize how awesome that was, because that was a big thing. I could have sat there thinking about that for hours. But no, it's a pretty simple solution to that problem. Rather than rewriting my whole system so that sequences return true, even if one child returned true, we created a new type of sequence called succeeder, which is already a behavior tree or design pattern or whatever you call that. And this means that when I hit the enemy, or when he does his hammer time, see, or this, yeah, if I hit him, yeah, okay, he didn't like undelay himself. Yeah, this is great. Okay, let's turn off, I'm gonna turn off only foes. Trotty bug. There's gonna be more types of enemies that need this sequence to work. Like that. ZX Flames, I know this is a cliche question about creating morphs, but I have made a few using VB6 engine. I don't know how I'd port a VB app to Java. I couldn't find good documentation. ZX Flames, I'm sorry I can't help you there. I have no idea about, I think you're talking about Visual Basic, right? I really don't know about porting a VB to Java. I don't use either of those languages, so. Sorry, I can't really help you there, man. I don't know. I guess you'd probably just try and ask some other people or try and search the net some more or start learning Java and, you know, and then just start learning how to port and stuff. I don't know. Okay, yeah, all right. Okay, so before I check this in, I said this is awesome right here too. This delay is now working. I want to go and apply this same succeed pattern to anything else that might be doing this whole if thing. All right, once again, we got to open up all the data. Blob boss does it, if ran smart, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that one's okay. If ran smart, that one looks good. This one needs succeeder right here. Oh, that explains why that wasn't working sometimes. So many things are all coming together with this fix. Sequence charge, this checks all out all its ifs first. So that's my general rule for fixing these up is if it starts with all ifs, it should still be a sequence. If it has an if followed by something else, followed by another if perhaps, that's where you really need to succeed. Here's another one. Yeah, hammer time. That one's okay. TJ, it's very cool that you got to implement that new decorator just because you had a good code structure and had implemented the pattern in the correct way. Yeah. Yeah, thanks, TJ. Thank you, man. I'm glad you can recognize that. I'm glad you did recognize that. Because, yeah, that is pretty cool. It's good to have a good system in place. You know what I mean? When your system's right, you can make a change like that, that fast, and see it happen. You know what I mean? So it's worth it to spend time making your systems really rock solid and awesome. Yeah. Because later on, it will pay dividends in when you're making little changes like this, and you're trying to figure out some little bug, and then you're like, oh. If that's good. Boomerang. Yeah, boomerang's okay. Pulverizer boss. That sequence is okay. Seek, that's okay. Blob. That one's okay. Okay. Blob zero. Yep. Blob two is looking good. Blob three. Kojal, what's up? Kojal, thanks for pre-ordering the game. Sorry about the confusion earlier. The problem, Kojal, was that I had another PayPal order right almost at exactly the same time you ordered. So I overlooked your second order, man. It was my fault, totally my fault. And then I noticed that, you did order twice. So, yeah, sorry about that again. You messed around in Bash? You mean the console? All right. Okay, so back to this. And so if anybody had just joined the game, I'm working on fixing up the bosses so that they increase in difficulty. They get more abilities as you get deeper into the dungeon. So the first dungeon, you might fight the drop boss with his big hammer, and he smashes the ground and stuff, and he only drops a few rocks on you. By the ninth level, he drops a ton of rocks on you. Nice, you've been lurking? Cool, man. Alright, so this is looking good. Cratchu, if, yep. These are good. I'm just looking for any other sequences where I might need to use this new succeeder pattern. That one's okay. Low battery. Karsh, here's another one. Ah, here's another one for sure. So when the Karsh launches its poison bubble, oh my god, this is really an important one too, because this one also has a delay. Oh, but you know what happened with this guy? he really didn't, it didn't affect him that much because this has a delay, that has a delay as well, and this is only something that runs at the very, very beginning. But still, this should be succeed. All right, good. That's great to find one more, but there's got to be I have a feeling there's a few more. That one's okay because it splits off into a select into a sequence. Same there. Ra's looking good. Yeah, Ray Meek. If good synth. All ifs around. Yep. Snakespear. These are sequences that he's not even running anyways. The little spider. Here he's another one. The spider's skitter sound. Oh, and that explains why the skitter sound wasn't working often. So many things are coming together. Understanding what the hell is going on. Spider. Yep, that was another one I was curious about. Man, I'm glad. This is a great fix. Thanks again, Jonah. Very, very, thanks for freaking researching that, suggesting that, because this is one of those things where, man, you really, really helped me out. I literally probably would have spent hours thinking up other ways to fix that situation, and it wouldn't have been as good as adding this succeeder pattern. Zurb. And we're looking good. Awesome. Fixed two bugs. Sweet. All right, this is ready to check in. Let me just double check it though. This is let's play one more time. Play this boss with everything. Wait, first I'm going to review the code and then play the boss a few times. So we got smart, the succeeder pattern. If ran smarts, make it so he drops more rocks depending on your dungeon depth. Here we go. K filter flow, I don't need that anymore. All right. We've got the succeeder pattern. Delays are more intelligent now. It could be a random range. This is great. This is a great looking check-in. Now I can just test a little bit more. That's right, MUDs. I forgot all about MUDs. What was one of the first MUDs? Was it Rogue? It wasn't Rogue, was it? What was that one where it was like you could go down and further and further into that text-based dungeon? Test right there when he lifts up his hammer and drops some more rocks. Wanted to make sure that he can't move. Yeah, that's great. So once again, he's like rock solid. Oh, that's how he didn't raise his hammer. That was kind of a bug. Mm-hmm. I was also noticing that the small explosions don't spawn the right global Z. I thought I fixed that. It was called mud, was it? The Robo dude, what's up, Robo? Yeah, Zork. Classic. What's up, Jayco? Okay, the next thing I want to do... I'm not going to worry about the small explosions. They're Z-ordered right now. I'm going to focus on... I want the ninth dungeon, same boss, to be... proper difficulty. So I want this guy to be a lot more difficult in dungeon 9. So I need the player to have enough life containers. So I'm gonna give him player like container 1, 2, 3, 4, like a lot, at least 8. Well, we got 10. And if yeah, 10, we already got 10, so let's take off 8. So he's got about that many life containers. We should have a bunch of bomb containers, but really it doesn't need to have that many. Let's put a few more. We should have the ghost sword by now for sure. And probably the extended top hat. But I'll leave that off. Let's definitely do the ghost sword. And probably a crafted bomb. So I'll do the lightning bomb. Let's give a player a lot of bombs. It's going to have a top hat also. Let's do the poison top hat. And the ghost sword combined with... fear, maybe, or ice, fire. Maybe let's do fire ghost sword. One level of shield. Okay, so that's about a lot of... that's a good queue of level 9 items we got here. I gotta fix these tiles. This is looking really weird here. There, it happened again. Yeah, whenever he's hitting one of these tiles with his hammer, it's like definitely screwing it up here. Unreal C++? Yeah, I think that'd be a great engine to start with. Well, if you know C++ already, I think Unreal is probably a great engine to be using. Hit points, that's for sure. This is level 9 for this boss. And man, I've been hitting him for a long, long time. He's still alive. that part's good. But I really think he should have, I think by now he should have got me at least like below half health. So I think his damage should double. That would help him be a little bit more. And I can see more rocks falling from the ceiling too. That's definitely something you should do if you're interested in that. But yeah, if it's too extreme for you, don't worry about it, man. I mean, that's something I'm capable of creating my own engine, but I definitely would never do that at this point in my game development career, because it takes forever to create your own engine. All right. Okay, so he needs more damage. Well, first of all, I'm going to check in what I got so far. This is a great fix already. So, and actually, I think I'm almost done with the stream today. Yeah, we're at 2 hours, so I'll run it one more time, but check in what I got so far. The room is destroyed. The room was destroyed. You see all those weird blocks? Okay, I'm gonna name this check-in succeeder pattern. All right. Or scratch your engine with code? Okay, let's see if I can fix that. That bug where it sinks the tile. Tile sink offset, that's it. Ah, and it calls add tile Z. Huh. So I want this tile when the enemy hits the tile with his hammer. I want it the global Z to be correct. Hell, maybe I just won't even change the Z. Let me just check. Oh, sorry. One time. I'll go to render system and set the auto Z for this entity. Set a breakpoint there, and I'll figure out what the hell it's doing when I change the Z slightly. Later on in the render system, it will go and update the Z for that tile, and that's, I think, what's giving it this weird Z order. So let's see what happens there. The Robo Dude, the bandwidth for my stream sucks right now. For a whole year of streaming, everything was fine. My Comcast internet was great. I pay for premium internet with Comcast, and then all of a sudden, like 2 or 3 months ago, my internet started being really sucky with how its upload rate. I used to get like 12 upload, and now I get like 4 upload. So I have to really cut back on the quality of my stream, and they still haven't fixed it. I've requested for them to come fix it. They came out to my house. They gave me, like, they fixed up some wires in my house, but they said, sorry, but we didn't actually fix it. We're going to have to actually send out another team and check out the telephone poles. They never, ever did that. So I got to call Comcast again and bug them once more and try and get them to fix my internet. So sorry about that, man. But yeah, bandwidth to the stream sucks. So the Z offset we have, or the Z, the Z itself is just -1. Z plus equals get tile Z. Okay, so Z must have been 0 to start. I guess I'm making an assumption there. Oh wow, this loops through every entity. Min, okay, min's -4. Okay, I'm gonna see what happens here with this set auto Z, and I'm getting close to finished with the today's stream here. Scamcast, right? I know, that's the problem. I'm with Comcast. And what sucks is I don't have any other choice except for AT&T. And I don't really think AT&T is going to be a better choice. They get pretty bad reviews around here. Yeah. All right, TJ, see you, man. So, okay, so I'm trying to figure out what's on with this global Z with the tile when it gets hit by the hammer. It starts at Z, -9999.38. Oh, there's what's going wrong. It's going to a totally different Z order layer because we're updating the Z. Yeah, so this render Z order layer is now mid. That's the problem. This thing should never be mid. Okay, so the way we could fix that is to update the e position.lastpause.z also, so it doesn't worry about that. We'll turn off this breakpoint. So now when I run it and it hits, the hammer hits the ground, should be proper. Custom namespaces, nice. Good job, Rocket Bunny. There we go. Cool. Let's get it. I'm going to make sure also that it's actually hammering. Yeah, look at that. So that thing was not quite as high. So let's watch it. Damn. I'm trying to catch him in the midst of his hammer. Obvious. Tile sync. At tau z, negative 1, min negative 4. Let's go all the way negative 4. All right, and this is going to be the last time I run the game for today's stream. Just checking to see if he, when he does his hammer, it really makes the tiles sink a lot. Yeah, there we go. So that's a big sink right there. Whoa. It ran his animation, but it didn't. The animation. Okay, so a lot of little bugs to fix up with this guy and make him even better than he was. But it's looking good. Got a lot of things already solved. They're really important. So that's it for today's stream. Thanks for watching, everybody, and catch you next time. Hope you guys have a good night. Thanks for watching. I appreciate y'all.